Hey horse people, that's a pretty good little video. Someone sent me about these horses are being taught how to swim. I'll turn down the volume here so I can this horse goes in pretty calm. They're gonna show a horse in a minute that goes in. So they have this
so that's a horse swimming pool here.
They have a nice setup. And it says Arabian horse swimming. I'm not sure where they're at. I thought I saw a sign at the beginning, maybe Saudi Arabia, but it's good exercise for a horse. Lets a horse damn controlled. I don't like the buckles on the halters. All those damn buckles get caught on shit. You know, when I point out a video, I'm going to point out good and bad. I know everybody wants to just see all the good, live in fairyland, and think that just because they're being nice, they can't do anything wrong. You can try to do the right thing and still do something wrong and hurt the horse. And, you know, bits, spurs, whips, all that crap, it hurts horses. Buckles on halters, they just get caught, they get tore up, they get snapped. They make it easy to put another piece of metal on there. I'm not a fan of them. And I've seen too many horses hurt by them. So, if I had to give them a suggestion, I like the fact they put these rubber mats at the end so the horse can get out without slipping. I tried to tell if this horse has shoes. I could not tell when it was walking off. I tried to slow and zoom in, and I'll put a link to the video. But you know, getting a horse to walk around water, getting him used to water, I think that's good for him. It's a good low impact exercise, just like humans. I don't think you ought to go out there and wear the horse out and make him run for 30 minutes when he's never, you know, swam, or make him swim for 30 minutes. But to give a horse exercise, to expose him to water, to let his skin get water, it kind of soothing, it's cooling. I can see how this could be beneficial either to an injured horse or a healthy horse. I haven't seen one of these swim pools. I know they have a couple for medical, but this is at some equestrian center where they built this. And they did a pretty nice job. They got mats at the front, mats at the back. Again, I'm not a fan of the halters. I mean, you could tie a rope to a rope halter or something. You need to control the horse's head because he may try to swim to the side and try to get out and hurt himself. So you definitely need having people on both sides will help steer the horse so he can't turn into the wall and end up getting trapped and try to climb out, maybe hurt or cut his hoof trying to jump. Again, I don't know how deep it is. It's deep enough to where he can't touch, because he's obviously swimming, but I don't know if he stood up straight on his back legs if he couldn't lunge up if he got caught on the side. And of course, the more they do it, the better they can get. Horses always do better for things they do most. I'm going to skip ahead here because they got a horse that's the first time. And so let's take a look at this first time horse. So you can tell his anxiety.
So that's the first time she's going down. Montasser, he was used to swim. عبد الناصر شو اسمه منتصر قصدي الحصان الماضي كان متعود. So he's okay.
Okay, first time swimming. Horse is nervous. You've already got the rope wrapped around his leg and trapped. Walking behind him, I don't think it's the smartest move. When a horse is nervous and his anxiety's up, he's distracted. So his eyes are forward like, holy crap, I'm going to be thrown in this water. And now you got somebody behind you thinking, oh, I know what I'm doing. I'm a horse person. And I'll just tap you on the butt. You know what? Just because something works doesn't mean it's right. This lady doesn't get kicked, but this is not a smart move. I would not do this. I don't think it's smart. When you get in a horse's blind side and you start tapping him and doing things and you overwhelm him sensory, his eyes, his hearing, he's going in fight or flight, he's nervous. Walking behind him is not the smartest thing. You know, now if this horse kicks this woman, it'll be this horse is dangerous. He kicked for no reason. She was only trying to help. So there'll be all these excuses on why the stupid human caused this, when in fact, it's just not smart. She shouldn't be there. But anyway, so we'll move on. The horse is obviously nervous, head high, can't focus. They're trying to force. They're putting pressure on both sides and behind. So this horse is under a great amount of stress right now. Is this a bad thing? Well, no, because they're doing it for a good reason. They're trying to take reasonable safety steps. They're trying to keep the horse away to where he doesn't get on these rails. If they let him get on one of these rails, if they only had one rope, then we'd have issues. So they're trying to take reasonable steps to get the horse in the water. Is it ideal? No. Would it be better if the horse had a pond and he could learn to swim by watching other horses and he went on his own? Absolutely, it would be good. But when we domesticate and we lock them up, sometimes we have to do things that aren't the best, but they're done in a safe manner to help the horse grow. And I think they're doing a pretty good job here. Okay, he's rearing. They're not putting too much pressure. Now she's coming in behind him, hitting him. Is this too fast? Because it had gone slower? Yeah, I think it could have went a little bit slower. Unfortunately, in the horse world, no matter where it's at, no matter what part of the world it's at, time is always an issue. Human want to work on human time instead of on horse time. Horse time is, you know what? It's how long it takes. I'll figure it out. Some horses are quicker. Some horses are slower. Some horses react more. Some horses react less. So horse time, when somebody asks how long should it take to break a horse, depends. It's all up to horse. It's horse time. How good are you? How are you doing things to help the horse so it'll take less time? Or are you forcing, trying to take shortcuts, doing it fast so it'll take more time and then you'll blame the horse? So if you work within a horse parameters, normally the slow way is the fast way. These guys are forcing it. They've got the horse where it can't get hurt. They do it fast. It works. Is it the best way? Maybe not, but it does work. And the horse doesn't get hurt. So, is there a better way? Probably. See, you notice how they're getting more of their angle? They're not protecting the horse. They're trying to put so much pressure forward and pull that they've lost their ability to keep the horse from going to the rail. So this horse, I think, because of this distance, could get to a rail and maybe get hurt and try to jump. So, I probably think they ought to stay more laterally on the sides of this horse so he can't have the ability to hurt himself because he's panicking. And then maybe just have pressure from the rear. But they want pressure from the front pulling and from the rear pushing. Now, the other side is, as they're moving away from the horse, they're creating a draw and they're releasing that forward pressure. So the horse is getting pressure from behind. It feels more pressure because he's insecure, and the people in the front are moving away, giving the horse the ability to move forward without feeling trapped or running into people. So, for the horse, very confusing, very unnatural, very stressful, going too fast. Is it the worst thing in the world? No. Could it have done better? Absolutely. When I'm trying to educate people on horses, I just want people to understand, if you see it through the horse's eyes, if you see what this horse is going through, and then you see what the people are doing to make the horse go through this, you can understand better ways and how maybe to relieve that stress and do it in a better way that causes less stress. So the horse is going to rear. The horse is either going to flip back and rear or jump forward. Those are his only two options. He can't go left or right. He's getting pressure in the front. He's getting pressure in the back. What do? I got to jump. I either go backwards. I'll just jump forward and run in panic and go into fight or flight. Is that best? Look at his panic. Look at the ears back. Look at the aggressiveness, the way he's swimming. Very, very telling signs that this horse, was this pleasurable? No. Was this the best? No. Did it work? Yes. Remember, just because something works doesn't mean it's right. I want you to look at this horse's expression again when he comes in here. The ears and aggressive, because this horse is absolutely in fight or flight. Watch those ears go back, man. He's just aggressively attacking this water. Those ears are straight pinned back. He's not relaxed. He's in a panic. The water's rushing. He's trying to run, looking for ground. He knows he can't go ground. In his mind, he's in survival mode. Are these people going to drown me? Am I never going to see life? Water isn't natural. This horse is acting in all total natural responses. And anybody that wants to see this for anything other than this horse isn't being bad, mean, crazy, whatever. And the humans are trying to be bad or mean either. They're actually trying to help the horse, and sometimes you've got to put the horse in stress to help it. He's swimming very hard. He's not using his feet easy. He's starting to calm down. He's figuring out, okay, I'm not dying. Okay, I'm kind of making it to the edge. Snorting a little bit. He's in panic, breathing hard. His nostrils, remember when a horse goes into fight or flight and runs, their nostrils expand twice the size. They suck in all this extra oxygen to get oxygen and blood to their muscles so they can run and fight, or flight and run. So he's still a little panicked when he comes out of there. Again, they got rubber mats. I like that. I mean, if you did this with concrete, you'd have a lot of horses slipping and falling. These sharp edges here on the concrete, I would probably try to make those more round and more, maybe put mats over them in case a horse goes to the side. If a horse gets over there, he can hurt himself and start driving. I mean, they've done a pretty good job, but just looking at things, always looking, if something can go wrong, it will with horses, and you kind of want to minimize every way possible that a horse could possibly get hurt. Okay, so they kind of rush in. Their rope handling skills are very weak. I mean, the way they ball these up, I mean, it's just a crisis. Never ball up ropes in your hands. I granted these things are long and they have to do something with them, but wrapping them around and getting them to where if a horse panic and runs and it traps your hand, not a good thing. I know everybody's going to be like, why are you being so critical and judgmental? You just can't fight. These people are doing... Shut up. I'm pointing out things that people need to observe and be aware of when they're dealing with horses. You can't just run around with pink lollipops thinking everything's going to be peachy keen, you know, because you're trying, or you mean well, or you love the horse, or you would never hurt a horse. The horse has to pay for your mistakes. And, you know, when horses do things and people get hurt, horses pay. They get blamed. They get labeled. They get locked up. They get handled with chains on their nose because they're dangerous. All things that happen to humans, horses end up paying for. So, I mean, again, they did a pretty good job. They're trying to do the right thing. The horse is getting some exercise. He got some exposure. He's very, very amped up right now. I would give him a chance to calm down, maybe not get too close to his face. He seems like he's doing okay. Is this lady going to give him a treat? Oh, my God. Okay, now, is that treat necessarily a bad thing? The only way that I see the treat's a bad thing is the lady carries around a big-ass pocket full of treats in her purse. Or in her little hip thing there. And each time she reaches in there and gives that to a horse, horses are going to learn. They learn very quickly. They're very observant. And they're going to start trying to get or grab that. And then she's going to have to start hitting and knocking horses away because they're trying to get her. And then they're going to try and bite. And then you get into this aggressive fighting. So, you know, it's kind of like walking out in a pasture with a bucket full of grain. People go out there and try to catch their horse with grain, thinking only their horse will know that it's their grain. And when five other horses come over and try to get grain, you end up with some idiot human running through the pasture, dropping grain, screaming, "The horses are trying to kill me! Help me! They're trying!" Instead of just dropping the damn bucket, or maybe not walking out in a damn pasture with a bucket in the first place. Good grief. All right. So, anyway, good little video, some lessons to be learned. And good things with horses. So I'm glad to see horses being treated good over here. All right, we'll end that there.